Okay, Greg. So I finally managed to read the article you mentioned. The one about the study on gender in physics.
About the study of college students done by Akira Miyake and his team. Yeah, I was interested that the researchers were actually a mix of psychologists and physicists. That's an unusual combination.
Yeah, I got a little confused at first about which students the study was based on. They weren't actually majoring in physics. They were majoring in what's known as the STEM disciplines. That's science, technology, engineering and...
And math. Yes, but they were all doing physics courses as part of their studies.
That's correct. So, as I understood it, Miyake and co. started from the fact that women are underrepresented in introductory physics courses at college. And also that, on average, the women who do enrol on these courses perform more poorly than the men. No one really knows why this is the case.
Yeah, but what the researchers wanted to find out was basically what they could do about the relatively low level of the women's results. But in order to find a solution, they needed to find out more about the nature of the problem.
Right. Now, let's see if I can remember. It was that in the physics class, the female students thought the male students all assumed that women weren't any good at physics. Was that it? And they thought that the men expected them to get poor results in their tests.
That's what the women thought, and that made them nervous, so they did get poor results. But actually, they were wrong. No one was making any assumptions about the female students at all.
Anyway, what Miyake's team did was quite simple, getting the students to do some writing before they went into the physics class. What did they call it?
Values affirmation. They had to write an essay focusing on things that were significant to them, not particularly to do with the subject they were studying, but more general things like music or people who mattered to them.
Right. So the idea of doing the writing is that this gets the students thinking in a positive way.
And putting these thoughts into words can relax them and help them overcome the psychological factors that lead to poor performance. Yeah. But what the researchers in the study hadn't expected was that this one activity raised the women's physics grades from the C to the B range.
A huge change. Pity it wasn't to an A, but still. No, but it does suggest that the women were seriously underperforming beforehand in comparison with the men.
Yes. Mind you, Miyake's article left out a lot of details. Like, did the students do the writing just once or several times? And had they been told why they were doing the writing? That might have affected the results.
You mean, if they know the researchers thought it might help them to improve, then they just try to fulfil that expectation?
Exactly.